She's me at the age of 26. When you have, long hair and your mustache is out to here and you want to solve everything, you want everybody to kumbaya, get
26,
around the campfire. Let them revel in the possibility that everything can be wonderful. That everybody in South Asia can have a Cadillac. I am not a socialist. I am a capitalist. I am a Republican.
But
I understand the generosity of the concept of socialism.
Slow down for a second.
What?
She says.
They were not going for that. Geraldo Rivera defending AOC last night, but renowned economist Thomas Sowell warns that many who are enthralled with the ideas that Geraldo talks about embracing are just not looking at the evidence.
So many people today, including in the leading universities, don't pay much attention to evidence. When you see people starving in Venezuela and fleeing into neighboring countries and realize that this is a country that once had the world's largest oil reserves, you realize that they've ruined a very good prospect with ideas that sounded good but didn't turn out well.
He makes a great point. Fox News roaming correspondent at large, Geraldo Rivera, joins me now. Geraldo.
Hi, Walter.
So you got a lot of pushback there last night, and we're all picturing you sort of in your Che Guevara T-shirt with your big mustache. But I mean, there's this feeling, I do think that, that some folks think that it feels cool, right? That, socialism is sort of this idea that everyone should have equality and everyone should sort of get what they need from the bureaucracy. But the problem is that the bureaucracy likes to take over. I mean, it empowers government so extensively that it leaves the people with no power at all.
I may be the only person in the country who supports both Donald Trump and Alexandria Ocasio-Cortez, Martha. In her case, the reason I am generally supportive of her is that she has been a tremendous inspiration to young people. She has gotten this whiny millennial generation off the couches in their mother's basements and instilled in them the possibility that they, maybe could even be more successful than their parents. I think it's been a woe is me kind of generation. They're laden
with
all
the
student debt.
But what in her message, Geraldo, is going to make them more successful than their parents?
That they can change the world, that they can seize the initiative, that they can be somebody, that they can, participate rather than drop out, that they can be energetic, they can be patriotic
in their own way. But she's espousing a system that will take away their power. That's what Sowell is saying. And, that's the underlying evidence that he talks about, that they're giving up their power.
I think that's going way too deep. I'm not arguing socialism versus capitalism
or economic theory. I get that she's an attractive character. Absolutely.
Well, there's definitely pride, ethnic pride and geographic pride. I think she's a great example to the youngsters in that congressional district and around the country in many ways. But I think that to be so harsh on her as if the Green New Deal was going to be legislation that's going to go into effect and cows can't fart and airplanes can't fly, I think that that is a bogus way of looking at her and the class that she represents. This is the most diverse. In many ways, the youngest. It is the most integrated Congress we've ever had.
I get you,
let them express these ideas. I understand that.
But they also do not have a memory of the Cold War. They don't have memory. There are plenty of present day examples, but they don't seem to believe that Venezuela accurately represents the danger of socialism to them.
Yeah, I was in law school in 1967, 1968, 1969. I got arrested in Washington. We were going to change the world. We didn't trust anybody over the age of 30. Our generation, maybe this generation is waking up the way mine did. Maybe we fell asleep, and now we pass the baton in our dreams to this next feisty generation. Let them make their mistakes.
We will watch.
Let them try to do something.
Nobody's stopping them. They are out there doing everything they want to do.
And
it is interesting to watch. Geraldo, thanks for being here. I just saw you on the street corner
this
afternoon. Now you're back in Ohio. That's why they call you the roaming correspondent. Roaming all day. Geraldo, thanks.
Now I'm in Cleveland.
All right. Good. We'll see you later. Thanks a lot.